to RSSDI TV 2020. I am Dr. Ruchi Shah, and on behalf of Wokhard RSSDI TV 2020, I welcome you all. I am glad to have with us today renowned endocrinologist from Bangalore, Professor Dr. L. Srinivas Murthy, sir. Sir is a senior consultant physician and diabetologist, Life Care Hospital and Research Center, Bangalore. Sir has a rich clinical experience in managing diabetes patients. Welcome Dr. Srinivas Murthy to the show.
Hi.
So, sir, based on your recent talk in RSSDI 2020 on an interesting topic and relevant topic of telemedicine and diabetes management, the do's and the don'ts, we would like to know from you, is it compulsory to undergo the training for teleconsultation?
No, as of now, it is not compulsory for the registered medical practitioners, RMPs, what we call it as. There is an online program going to be designed by the Government of India. In the span of next 3 years, within 3 years, they need to undergo this training. It will become mandatory by 2023, March.
So, sir, what is the significance of taking a consent before teleconsultation?
Yeah, I think consenting is very, very important even during our routine procedures, as all of you know. But during teleconsultation, the consenting is becomes very, very important, because after which only you can continue to consult the patient. So there are two types of consenting in the telemedicine. One is called the implied consent, where the patient has initiated. The patient calls you through video or audio or through a chat. Initiation is by the patient side. It's called implied consent, and you need not do anything. Explicit consent is something where someone has initiated the consult, either caretaker or health worker, that should be obtained. In such case, wherein you are going to call them up voluntarily from the physician's or RMP's side, then it becomes a explicit consent, where it is very important for you to document what kind of consenting, whether it was through a video consenting, telephonic consulting, or a WhatsApp or SMS. And the advantage of teleconsultation is that, you know, you can literally talk to the patients, communicate with the patients, whatever the means. For example, a very rural interior place, you can just have a normal phone and you can make it as a telephonic consultation taken prior to this consultation. That is all you need to. But everything to be documented, and the prescription should mimic your physical prescription, which you're going to give in a face-to-face consultation. So consenting forms the key first step towards your teleconsultation.
Okay. So, sir, the last question, how has telemedicine emerged and helped during the current ongoing difficult COVID pandemic times?
Yeah, I think this is where the telemedicine has taken the front seat. And if you remember, till last year, we never had any guidelines for the telemedicine, but Government of India, looking into this pandemic in March 25th of 2020, came down with the telemedicine guidelines. So telemedicine allows the patients to consult with their physicians away from the hospital, which could lower chances of COVID infections. I think this pandemic, this is the greatest invention what we have, is to, you know, prioritize and utilize these teleconsultations in our practice. Though it was sustained, it was there existing all these years, but now I think physicians can interact with the patient, gather their history, analyze their SMBGs, especially with diabetics, and even the blood pressure can be looked at. In fact, there is a meta-analysis, Cochrane review has shown that there is a reduction of A1C by about 0.31% in patients on telemedicine when compared with the control group. So very, very important. International telemedicine initiatives are bringing the world closer now, and distance is no longer a barrier in attaining the quality healthcare. And that is the best part about telemedicine. And the governments are now starting to take a keen interest in developing telemedicine practices in future, and it can be utilized effectively in the management of diabetes during this COVID-19 pandemic and even afterwards. And that is the best part about the technology, what we need to accommodate and helps ourselves to treat the patients in a better way, so that we have a healthier society.
So thank you so much, sir, for sharing your views on this very recent and relevant topic in the COVID times about the telemedicine diabetes management. And stay tuned to RSSDI TV 2020, brought to you by Wokhard, for more recent updates from RSSDI 2020. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.